Today I will show you how you can predict where the cueball is gonna go after you made contact with the object ball by using the tangent line. Really, everyone who's playing pool should know how to use the tangent line in order to get position for the next shot. And if you don't know how to do that, don't worry, in about 5 minutes you will know everything that you have to know. The first step to use the tangent line is the ability to play a stop shot. I'm gonna explain that real quick, because there are maybe some beginners watching this video right now. A stop shot means that the cue ball has no forward or backward rotation when it hits the object ball. If you're straight, it's called a stop shot. If you have an angle, it's called a stun shot. There are two ways to play a stop shot. The first step, play the shot hard, hit the cue ball a little below center. The cue ball is now sliding over the glove till it hits the object ball and will stop at this position because all the energy is transferred to the 9 ball. The other way to play it, where you can play it a little softer, is aim lower on the cue ball and then pull the trigger. The cue ball now has backwards rotation, but at some point the cue ball changes from backward to forward rotation, and at this moment the cue ball slides for just a short moment. At this moment, you have to hit the 9 ball. Otherwise, the cue ball would follow the 9 ball a little bit, because then the cue ball has forward rotation. Now we can start to talk about the tangent line. There's the 9 ball somewhere on the table, and we want to hit the 9 ball into this direction, because there maybe is a pocket. We now have to imagine the ghost ball. Ghost ball means, where will our cue ball hit the 9 ball in this case? Now we're moving the potting line slightly back so that it touches the center of the ghost ball. So the line goes from the center of the ghost ball through the center of the 9 ball. Just a little reminder for the ghost ball principle: if we aim to the center of the ghost ball, we will hit the 9 at the right spot in order to make it. Now we can draw our tangent line. As you see, the tangent line has this 90 degree angle, and this 90 degree angle is really important to predict where the cue ball is gonna go after we made contact with the 9 ball. This is the line where the cue ball is coming from. As you see, the cue ball travels straight towards the 9 ball, so we're gonna play a stop shot. This is pretty easy, but now the tangent line comes into play. If we move that line to the left, now the cue ball is coming from this angle. As you see, the cue ball now hits the 9 ball and travels along the tangent line because of that sliding cue ball. So the cue ball travels, hits the 9 ball and will exactly slide along that tangent line if you have a perfect sliding cue ball. And even if we change the angle where the cue ball is coming from now, what happens is the cue ball is gonna travel along the tangent line as well. It doesn't change because the contact point at the 9 ball doesn't change. No matter where you are coming from, you will always have that 90 degree angle that we have drawn in the beginning. So even if you're coming from this side, if you have a perfect sliding cue ball, the cue ball will always gonna travel along the tangent line. Of course, if you're coming from this side, then the cue ball is gonna go down and it's gonna travel along this part of the tangent line. And that's the whole principle. But you have to train this. So set up whatever shot you want. You can use the tangent line on every shot. Then go behind the shot, imagine the potting line. Go towards the side, imagine the tangent line. And mark it with some chalk on the rail. Now you can control yourself how well you can see the tangent line already. If you're not that good, maybe ask a teammate for help. Yeah, he should just draw the potting line with his cue, so it's easier for you to see that 90 degree angle of the tangent line. Another way to test that, a little tougher way, just visualize the tangent line again, then take two balls and put them along the tangent line. The closer you put them together, the harder it gets to maneuver the cue through this gap. But if you have a perfect imagination of the tangent line and a perfect sliding cue ball, then the cue ball has to travel through the gap. Of course, if you hit too low and have a little bit of draw on this shot, then you will hit the 3 ball in this case. And if you hit a little too high, yeah, then you will hit the 6 ball, because the cue ball will leave the tangent line. Another way to test how well you see the tangent line, just set up a shot and then move the cueball around to see where the cueball has to be to get the right tangent line. Please be careful. Now think about my last statement where I said you should move the cueball in this case to find the right tangent line to go through that gap. We learned that the tangent line isn't depending from where the cueball is coming, because that contact point is always the same. So wherever the cueball is, the tangent line will never change. So we don't have to move the cueball to get the right tangent line, we have to move the object ball. That was just a little test to check if you're understanding the principle of the tangent line completely. That's it for this lesson, I hope you enjoyed it. Subscribe, leave me a comment, watch some other lessons, and that's it for today. See you at the next video.